Hello, Umbraco gang. It's me, Warren. And today we're going to mix things up. Rather than me do some hacking today, I've invited one of my colleagues along. He's going to show you how to do integration tests with Umbraco. So here's Nikolaj. Hand it over. Watch this awesome demo.
Hello, everyone. Let's talk about integration tests. So today I'm going to show you how to set up a site, download it as a package, and then use that schema for your integration tests. So I've set up a pretty basic site here with a homepage, some news, and some news articles. What you want to do is go to the packages section here. You want to go to the created, and then you want to create package. I'll just call this my demo package. I'll choose some content. I'll go with the homepage. It has all the child notes, so let's include those. Let's include all the document types for it and the language. Then, is there anything else new? Maybe the templates, actually. We might want those. Yeah, and create. And then we download the package. And now you already have a schema we can now use to set up the integration tests. Okay, so now we're in IDE. We're ready to start integration testing, right? No, not quite. As you can see here, I've moved the package.xml into the project and next to my test file. What you want to do is you want to go to properties for this file. You want to choose a build action, and by default, it's probably none. And you want to choose embedded resource here. Okay, so now we're ready to test, right? Not quite. We still need a NuGet package. Well, for this, we can use umbraco.cms.test.integration. You can see I've already handled it here, searched for it, and installed it. So that was lucky for me. And we have to derive from Umbraco integration test, and it lives in that namespace. And you can see right here, we'll just type the using for you. You might want to do it manually. And we still need to do the attribute. Umbraco test. Right? Yeah. So we want to here for the database, we want to do Umbraco test options. We want to choose the database and we want to choose a schema here. So now you can choose an empty database if you want. But we already went through the trouble of setting up the website and stuff, so let's do new schema per test. You can also do it for the whole fixture, but I would do it for every test, just so you have the same state for every test. The other might come in handy. Okay, so now we're ready, right? Not quite. We still need to install the package. So let's do that. So for VirusML package migration resource, let's do git embedded package container, because we just embedded it, right? Chose embedded resource, so let's do that. And then we need the packaging service to actually install it. Let's do var packaging service, and we have a very helpful method called get require service. This can get any service, of course not any service in the world, but you know what I mean, every service we have registered, at least. So, packaging service dot install compile package data, and we luckily already have some package data in the XML var here. So now we're ready to test, and now we have already set up the schema every time the test runs. So this will run on our site now, and not just with a blank site. So that's nice. So let's do var content type service. Service of I content type, and you might wonder why I'm doing this, but you can see I've already actually named the tests. This will ensure that no content will exist after the doc type is deleted. So when we delete a doc type, all the content that's made from that doc type should probably disappear. So let's delete all of them. So let's do var content types, name content type service dot get all. So now we're getting all the document types out. So let's do it for each loop of those, for each in content types, for each content type. And maybe I should do a better job of naming this. So let's do that. And let's do that. So let's just delete them all. So we can do that with the content type service. Dot delete. And then we will delete the content type. Yep. So now we've deleted all our document types. So now there should be no content. Let's test it out. So we need a content service to get all our content. So we can do get required service again of I content service. And then let's see if there's any content. Well, contents, maybe. It's not the best name. But get stu. Oh, I see the error. Consent service. That's not what we want. We want an iContent service. So now we can do get. Ah, there's all my gets. Let's do get root content. I was wondering why that is. Okay. Let's just assert there's no content. Assert dot r equal 0 and then the contents. Let's do that. And now that we have the content type service, let's make sure there's no content types either. Content type service dot get all. And let's do dot count, of course. Dot count. Or is this, we're just returning into this. Do we need anything else? We probably don't. Let's run it. Let's blast it. And then let's pray that it works. So there's something not set to an instance of an object. That's not good. What's that? Line 28. So that's not good. So probably we will not have to delete content types. Oh, what's happening? So you see here in my site. So deleting this, and then of course the child with it. So when it gets to the child, it's not there. So this is not the right way to do it. So if content type dot parent ID constants dot system dot root. Let's get the right constants. Let's do the core one. System dot root. So this is just the ID. Minus one. So if it's the root node, we can do delete. And we should probably make some brackets just to have the best standards. And then let's run these tests again. And now we pray it works. Hopefully. Let's see it. Have it on good. Yes! So as you can see, we set up a schema, we deleted some content, and then we tested if the content was gone. Easy as that. And now, you might think, Nikolaj, there was no content to begin with. So let's actually just, this is not the best practices, but just to ease your mind, let's do content. What did we call it? Content types dot, not just content type dot count. Oh, assert. R equal, and then the count should be larger than 0, and then of course true. So this will throw an error if this is not larger than 0. So let's stop our tests and then let's run it again. And let's see if this one passes. Just to ease your mind that there was actually content to begin with, or content types. Yep. So you can see as it is, it succeeded. So there was actually some content or content types, and then we deleted them, and then we asserted there's no content, there's no content types. So you can see the schema works just fine.
Thanks, Nikolai. That was an ace demo. Hopefully you enjoyed that too. Until next time, carry on hacking. I look forward to seeing what you're working on in the Umbraco community. Let me know. Bye. Blah, 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 blah.